So back to code gibberish section, and in this module we are going to be talking about animation part 2. So this is where we stopped in the last tutorial. We are able to go ahead and create this little animation that spring up and it works fine. So let me just go ahead and just add some couple of things. The other things to add right here is to define the sequence of this animation. How many times do we want it to run? As you can see, if I reload, it's only working in one sequence, which is one time like that. So how do I want it to continue working forever, or to actually go ahead and be moving around or working with just in a kind of a logical way? Maybe it's going to be reverse or kind of alternate reverse. Let me do this, guys. I'm talking too much. So animation iteration count, animation iteration count allow us to specify the number of times that we want to run this animation. So let me just go by 3 times. So what I'm saying is I want to run this, I want to be moving from yellow to blue 3 times. So let's go, guys. So 1, 2, 3, and can you see? So what do I do? Let me just go ahead and count again. 1, 2, 3, like that. So it's able to run 3 times. What if we want this to run forever? So if we actually want it to run forever, instead of positive 3, we're just going to say infinite. Everybody know what infinite means? Infinite actually means something endlessly. So as you can see, I'm having this running endlessly, so it's just going to continue running as long as the server is up, the browser is up, until you close the page. That is when it's going to stop running. So it's just going to continue running like that. So it's very, very important for you to know more about animation iteration count. Another thing I want to show you is animation direction. So the direction of the animation too is very, very important. We have just 2 attributes, or let me say 3 attributes. We have normal, which is what we are using by default. We have alternate, like there, and we have reverse. So alternate actually is different from reverse. So alternate usually looks like normal, and I believe those are the default value, because alternate means that, okay, when this animation is running, you just go alternately. So we are moving from background color of yellow to background color of blue and some kind of stuff like that. So that's how we are actually doing our movements. And if I could go ahead and use reverse, you are going to see how these guys are going to work. So reverse actually means that, okay, instead of moving from background color of yellow to blue, I'm moving from background color of blue to yellow. So, and that is what reverse means. So it's just coming from the last one set here and go to the first one, which is supposed to be. So let's check this out, guys. So we start from blue, come to yellow, from blue again, come to yellow, and that is because we are having reverse. So let's look at alternate. So you see, from yellow to blue, then from yellow to blue again, it's going to go yellow to blue again. And I told you already, so alternate just me follow the number sequence, and the reverse mean just start from the beginning. So alternate reverse 2, we also have alternate reverse. Let's say it's just going to work like reverse. Can you see it's going to work like reverse, going from blue to yellow. I can see it's actually starting from the bottom, going from blue to yellow, so it just works like reverse. So I would prefer you, if you actually want to reverse, use alternate reverse. I think so. I've been using that for very long, so it's been working. Probably I feel like it's much more explanatory when they updated it to have alternate reverse than just having reverse or alternate like that. Alright, guys, so this is a very, very important. I need you to actually take note of it. Very, very vital important. So in the next tutorial, I'm just going to introduce you to some couple of things in animations, which is very, very important to note too.